Metal Gear Solid 5, Ground Zeroes, Tactical Espionage Operations. So, I've had a lot of questions on different parts of the channel, on various videos, and on Twitter, asking if I'm gonna play Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain. And I figured this is about the clearest answer I can give, which is to just play Ground Zeroes a couple days before it comes out, and give you guys that. Because then it's like, yes, I'm playing Phantom Pain. Just so you guys know. Apparently it has a continue. Have I launched this game before? Weird. I have previously played this game for the SAD games back when it was back when it was newer, at least. Probably 6 months ago. But, basically, not only is this a little warm-up for you guys, if you guys haven't seen what happens at Ground Zeroes before we start Phantom Pain, but I also want to play it because this will give me a nice opportunity a few days before the game comes out to, let's say, warm up, because Metal Gear has very specific controls, usually, that don't really jive with any other game. Sometimes it looks like a third-person shooter, but definitely does not control like one. You still control your character more like a character action game to some extent, where it's like very specific control, and it's hard to explain. Specifically in Metal Gear Solid 3 with their close quarters combat system, they can get really weird and unique with their controls, so it's good to get some practice in. So for those of you that don't know, this is Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes. It came out probably a year ago now, actually, on the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, and eventually, I believe, on PC. I think that was at a later date. It's a prologue. I think it takes place 9 years before before Phantom Pain, as a Snake here. Or is he Big Boss? It gets a little confusing. Anyway, mission select. Yeah, I will start a new mission. So this game actually has a whole bunch of stuff going on, as you can tell from this mission screen here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there's 6 other missions besides the main one. This is the Ground Zeroes story. If someone talks about playing Ground Zeroes, they're generally talking about this. But after I beat this, you do unlock 6 bonus missions. I'm not going to be doing those right now because Phantom Pain comes out in like a couple days, and I'm going to be busy with that. But I might come back to these at some point as a little side project. But anyway, it's probably because they made this main campaign, and it's like, oh, it's over in like an hour and a half. People aren't going to be happy to spend like $30-$40 on that. Well, we'll make 6 missions that also take place in that area that are not really important to the story necessarily, but they're like little challenge missions to add more content. Anyway, without further ado, let's get started. In an era when the world was divided into East and West, the boss, the mother of special forces and hero of World War II, defeated the Soviet Union. Under orders from the US government, her final apprentice, Naked Snake, took her life. But for the boss, her defection was no more than a cover. She was made to sacrifice herself to prevent nuclear war. I wasn't done with that page. That was her final mission. The boss used Snake to ensure that the philosopher's legacy, the vast military fund under the Soviet Army control, would reach America. For these outstanding accomplishments, Snake was awarded the title Big Boss. And that's who we are. After turning his back on America, Snake began recruiting soldiers with the help of Kazuhira Miller, a man who he first met on a war zone. In 1974, the pair constructed a secret base in the Caribbean. Snake's private army continued to grow until the need for a deterrent prompted them to obtain a nuclear weapon. Meanwhile, Major Zero, the man who once worked with Snake to create Special Forces Unit Fox, used the philosopher's legacy to expand his intelligence organization, Cipher. Cipher proceeded to spread its roots into the furthest depths of the United States. With no military of his own, Zero longed to rejoin his old comrade Snake, and sent his operative Paz to make contact. Paz attempted to steal the nuclear weapon, Oh no! I lost the story. They took me out of the story. You guys are mean. They made this. Aw, why'd you make the menu? I was trying to read fast. I kept running faster and faster. I'm like, damn it, I can't do it in time.
Thank you. us everything. Don't worry, I kept my word. He didn't suffer long. Here. You earned it. How's it feel to play the traitor? No more war games. You're a real man now, soldier. Give my regards to your boss when you get home.
Days ago, we got reports that Paz was still alive.
She survived.
She was rescued by a Belizean fisherman who found her drifting in the Caribbean.
So what's the plan? Silence her before we're compromised?
No. I've got something else in mind. Our friends at Cipher suspect Paz could be a double agent. She's being held for interrogation at a camp on the southern tip of Cuba.
Black site. Nice. A slice of American pie on communist soil and out of U.S. legal jurisdiction.
The upcoming inspection of Mother Base has to be connected somehow. The timing's too perfect.
The UN's nuclear inspection.
My guess is they're trying to corroborate Paz's link.
We're an army without a nation.
Word of our capabilities gets out, and we'll have the whole world out to shut us down. Having an American private intelligence agency involved, bad news. Cipher's the ones who sent Paz to us in the first place.
She knows the true nature.
Right. Paz is our only link to Cipher. If she's still alive, we need her on our side.
The other target?
That would be Chico. He's being held in the same area as Paz.
last radio contact was 40 hours ago. Find them both. Bring them back alive. Enter the compound from the south cliff. Secure Chico and Paz, then report back from the rendezvous point. Send a chopper from across the Cuban border. You should be back at Mother Base in time for lunch. You'll probably just miss our guests. The only catch is you go in solo. The politically sensitive nature of the mission needs backup is not an option.
Fine. I like some alone time now and then.
So first of all, the cutscene, as you may have noticed, was all one unbroken shot. That Hideo Kojima's taking very specific influences from filmmakers there. So the scene started over by the prison camp, and we actually went into a helicopter via a jeep, then flew across the sky with a helicopter, and then followed the patches down to the cliff, then followed then we attached a snake and followed up the cliff up to here, and then we smoothly transitioned into gameplay. And there was no cuts in the camera. That's a very, very long unbroken shot, actually. And so we're our two goals here are to find Chico and Paz. They're in two different locations of this huge sort of open world stealth area we need to navigate through. Now Snake's voice acted not by David Hayter, which is the standard voice actor for David for Solid Snake, and I think Naked Snake also in Metal Gear Solid 3. Instead, he's played by Kiefer Sutherland of 24 fame, which is a point of controversy because people get very attached to their voice actors that they've had around for like 15 years or so. And you saw the big flashlight, you saw the big beacon on Hideo Kojima there during. And unfortunately, this game and the next game, Ground Zeroes, are probably the last we'll ever see of Hideo Kojima or Kojima Productions on any Konami game. Granted, we might not see Konami games anymore. Because not only has Konami separated themselves from Hideo Kojima, they may be done with video games in general.
What do you see? Press the call button to get more intel. Your binoculars are equipped with a directional microphone. You should be able to listen in on whatever they're pointed at.
Alright, so who do I listen to then?
You should try listening in on those soldiers. Even casual chatter could reveal something in a place like this. Head for the old prison. You'll find the targets there.
Okay, he says those soldiers. Is there a more obvious pairing of soldiers? I don't see one. Oh! That's not how you zoom. R3 is zoom. Okay. Whoa, significant zoom. Okay. Maybe if I zoom all the way in? Hey, guy.
It's a guard. Don't let him see you. Avoid combat whenever possible.
Alright, so that's how we get the icons over their heads, which lets us tag them and track them wherever they go. Which is pretty handy from a stealth perspective, because you can keep track of patrols that way, as long as you spot them. And the hard part is spotting them. One of them was walking around earlier, and I've already lost line of sight of them. Oh well. So this is running at a pretty smooth frame rate. I believe it's running at a solid 60 the whole time.
Keep low. You can check the controls on the pause screen.
There we go.
Those are U.S. Marines on watch. Not the type to go easy on intruders.
Yo, that gear they're asking for? I loaded it into the truck.
Thanks, man.
What the hell do they need that for?
Apparently, knocks you out cold. Just like that. No fatality.
Knocks you out? Like a stun gun?
I guess. Couldn't get him to tell me anything else.
I was getting pretty close to saying that, this will probably be even faster than the, roughly 100 minutes or so it took me to play this game the last time about 6 months ago. But, probably gonna take me longer, because on this channel, I actually pay attention to what people are saying. And that generally makes everything take way longer. Alright, well, we've got about all we're gonna get tagged from here. So first problem is watching out for this guy's, his light. Probably gonna have to take the light out in some way, unless I can run through. Let's see.
If you ready your weapon while crawling, you can move horizontally left or right. If you do that holding the dash button, you'll move faster.
Uh oh. Did he just look at me? Alright, cool. So it said L2. There's a few controls to figure out here at the beginning, so it'll be off to level slightly.
You can use your iDroid to check all sorts of operational data. The map, objectives, the target's locations. It'll help a lot if you let it.
There we go. So L3 is the sprint button, that's important to know. So I'm gonna wait for the light to go by, and then I'm gonna try to sprint right past the spotlight. But the downside is that there might be a sound component that might get me detected. Oh, that actually might have been my opportunity, huh? Go, 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 go. Uh-oh. I may have made a terrible mistake. Silent pistol. Oh, shit. Well, mistakes were made. Immediately. I thought I'd get past him without being spotted. Alright, let's figure out how to get inside. Oh, I'm in trouble. Immediately. Literally not getting off the first beach area before getting trapped. Let's see, we'll let the alarm... That's fine, we'll let the alarm drop. The whole point of this exercise is to get into the mode of how to play these games. I'm essentially using this as training camp for Ground Zeroes, so you're gonna watch me shake the rust off. You gonna leave?
Looks like they've lost visual on you.
It's actually a good time to spot a bunch of guys as they come out. Oh yeah. Alright, they opened the gate for me, that's nice. And then it closed on that guy. Ooh. I can spot another one. I see you. We're spotting all sorts of guys around here. Let's see. And there's the map of the entire area. You can see all the guys that I've tagged so far, including the truck that's way out there, are actually still being tracked. Here's my goal, which is to get to the
This is the location where prisoners of war are kept. Looks like they're leaving. Alright, that's what I was hoping for. After we save Chico here, we're gonna have to find Paz somewhere. I believe she's like way over here or something like that in the big structure. Basically, the idea is to the idea of this to show off their whole game and what Ground Zeroes is gonna be. I mean, what Phantom Pain's gonna be is like, all right, here's an outdoor stealth mission, here's an indoor stealth mission. Best of both worlds. All right, so those guys are well and truly cleared out. Oh, funny how that goes.
Understood. Keep your guard up. Out.
Now head east to the old prison area. You can bring up the target's location on your iDroid. Eyes open, boss.
Did he really just spot me just like that? Crap.
CP, this is Zulu 10. I just saw someone suspicious.
Oh, you check son of a bitch.
Over.
Are you both coming to check it out?
Understood.
Oh, you both are. Do I have a distraction? That's not a distracting item. That's not a distracting item either. Oh, night vision goggles. None of these are helpful. Alright, well, I'm just gonna have to deal with these guys. Probably gonna have to knock them out or something. There's two of them though, so I'm in trouble! That was my bad. I thought that was the lock to an object button.
CQC is effective for dealing with nearby enemies.
Oopsie! Boom. Oopsie. Let's just take some. Let's get some movement here.
Zulu 10, this is CP. Give me a sit rep. Do you copy?
Someone's gonna be checking on them soon.
We have a situation. All units on alert.
Oh yeah. I'm about to get caught. If I don't get out of here. Did that song get burned in my brain already? We only listened to it for a little bit. All right. That light looks like it's pointed my way. Those guys are all investigating the bodies. Those guys might get woken back up. Alright, so this is obviously not a perfect stealth run. Yeah, that initial mistake was like, oh yeah, that must be the button that you used to lock to cover. Nope. Looks like you kind of smart locked to cover. So that was just the button you used to go over the thing you're hiding behind. Do I want to go behind here? Let's see. No one can see me here, so hopping on this ladder might be an opportunity. Get a nice line of sight and scout out more patrols if I don't get spotted on here. Nope, hide behind the thing so he doesn't see me. Cool. No one over there.
CP, this is Delta 3. We're standing down here. No hostile spotted. Over. This is CP. Understood. All fire teams, return to your posts. Out.
I see you. It's not working.
Take a good look at the enemy through your binoculars, and you can mark him. Marked enemies can be sensed when nearby, even if there's a wall between you and them. But it only works if you stop and take the time to focus your attention. This helps you maintain situational awareness. Try it.
So they're all over the place. Let's see. Have I gotten any closer? Oh, yeah, this is the wrong direction to go in, though. Finding a few things that are worth marking, of course, but this is where I'm trying to go. Out in that direction. Let's be careful. Ooh. I see you, buddy. There we go. Not sneaking up on nobody. Ooh. It's a whole crew of them in there. There we go. A lot of them move in groups, so that makes it even easier to track them. Because you're more likely to... The more you track, the more likely you're to track. The more likely you are to know the locations of ones you don't even know about yet, because they'll often walk around as one unit. Alright, I might want to cut through the middle of this camp if I think I can. Though maybe I don't have a reason to think I can. That stoplight's gonna be a problem, though. I mean, that spotlight, not stoplight. Damn you, words that have the same letters in them! Alright. No one's checking on those guys, huh? That guy's that guy has dash lines, and the other one has Z's. I think that's because one of them got knocked out by the pistol, which means he's asleep, and the other one's, like, knocked out as an unconscious. I hope. I don't know why they'd keep tracking the body if he's dead. He might be dead, though. The dots.
That rain just won't let up. It'll help you stay out of sight. But watch you don't get hypothermia.
feel like hypothermia is not going to happen to me in the 1 hour of this game, though, in this scale. Hey, buddy, you looking around? Cool, not looking in this direction. I'm in the open, so this is not the greatest place to be. Let's get into a camp. So that a car passing by doesn't see me. Just being cautious. Oh yeah, that car's coming right through, isn't it? Or maybe it's going by the spotlight. Alright, it looks pretty clear. I think we can make some good progress here. Just hug corners. Don't surprise anyone. Oh, let's stay out of the light. That's just asking for trouble, I think. Yeah, we're gotten a lot closer. Kind of laterally, but still, we're doing okay. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that I haven't killed anyone yet. I think CQC just knocks people out by default. That was a pretty swift knockout too. I just slammed his head into the wall. That's a video game and movie thing though. If you knock people out through blunt force, they often get brain damage or die. Not a very. If I was the bad guy in a movie, I'm saying, and I needed a hostage or needed to capture someone, you don't want to knock them out, because you might kill them, and then that's... you're kind of fucked at that point. Ooh, I see you. It's actually really good to mark these guys, because they're hard to see. You can hear the microphone there, too. You can actually hear him walking around. Startled me for a moment, because I thought someone was right next to me. I'm like, oh god, where is he? Alright, so I gotta sneak past this guy. Or anyone else, and no one's in the booth. So ideally I would distract him with something, but I might be able to creep around that fence over there. Which direction is this guy looking in? He's looking over here, of course, which blocks that path. So I suppose, oh, he's going away. It might be my best path. Just don't look over here, buddy. That's what Metal Gear games are. That's what stealth games are. Don't look over here. The game. This looks open. Sweet. Yeah, the front path clearly had a guard in it. Getting good use out of these binoculars so far. So who's guarding the prison camp? So yeah, this is the prison camp where everything started. It's a little blurry because the camera's not focusing. That might have... knowing fucking Kojima's attention to detail and quirkiness, I wouldn't be entirely surprised if that was not, like, a weird thing, like... intentionally made it blur more often when it's raining, because it makes it harder to focus a camera. There we go. So there's one guy out front. No one in the tower. That's noteworthy.
I've sent VIs of the targets to your iDroid. Take a good look.
That's all we have. Alright. Let's take a look. Menu, display information.
This is the transmission we intercepted. Chico's call for help.
Snake, it's Chico. I need your help. Cipher's holding me on a U.S. military base in Cuba.
That was short. Alright. Rescue Mother Base member Chico and high-value target Paz from a U.S. naval prison facility. And escape the mission area by chopper. Target Chico and Paz.
Paz, it's here too. You're at the prison area on the coast. There's some cages to the east of a big building. East and old grassy facility. That's where we are. Help me, Snake.
Their lives are in your hands. Get Chico and Paz out of there.
And those are photos of my two targets in adjacent cells. Right there. Alright, what's down here? Cassette tapes? Do I have cassette tapes to play? I have no tapes. Sadness. Oh god. Alright, you want to know everything you ever want to know about video games? Oh my god, how many reports are there? That's terrifying. Paz's tape is discovered.
I heard about Paz's tapes. Yeah. Why do you think she'd leave him behind? And that diary?
Whatever it was, her commitment was wavering. That much is clear.
So she was leaving clues. To help us.
No way to know for sure. And the ocean's not giving her back.
November 4th, 1974. At the outskirts of Barranquilla, Colombia. Contact with Big Boss successful. Zadornov posed as my professor, but Big Boss took one look and knew he was KGB. However, he does not seem to suspect me. To him, I am just a peace-loving student and another victim of the CIA. We asked him to drive the CIA out of Costa Rica. To him, this means betraying his country. His forces are smaller than anticipated. They drift from place to place with nowhere to call home. That provided us an opportunity, so we seized it. Zadornov offered them a plant off the Costa Rican coast to use as a base. As expected, Miller jumped at the chance. Although initially reluctant, Big Boss came around when Zadornov played in the tape. All because the voice on it sounded like his mentor, the boss. Naked Snake, the man who once saved the world from the brink of nuclear war. Awarded the title of Big Boss for his service. He later became a mercenary, abandoning both his title and his country. To him, that honor was steeped in the blood of the boss, the mentor he was forced to eliminate. Exceptionally charismatic, he possesses unparalleled combat and intelligence-gathering abilities. His only discernible weakness is...
We've been in touch with Amanda. We had her listen.
This operation hinges on how effectively we can exploit that.
I know my brother, and I know when he's lying. She also had a message for you.
Kazuhira Miller is Big Boss's lieutenant. Half Japanese, half American. He once served in Japan's self-defense force. Though he and Snake first met as enemies, they discovered a common bond and together built their private army, with Miller directing business and administrative affairs. He comes off as shallow, but his true intent is hard to read. I must be careful. All that is clear is his infatuation with Big Boss. With East and West fighting over its control, Central America is now the most contested region on Earth. CIA Central American Station Chief Coldman has developed Peace Walk, a fully AI-automated, fail-deadly nuclear launch system with which he aims to reignite the Cold War. Snake's new objective in Costa Rica is to prevent that. Zadornov's, or should I say, the KGB's plan is to play the two sides against each other, turning the entire region red. Not one of the three parties realize they're all just pawns in Cipher's hands. Cipher watches all. Mother Base has developed rapidly since being established in the Caribbean Sea.
You can also climb back up or let
they recruit
drop.
More personnel
just
daily,
sure
and already their mercenary services are turning a profit. Big Boss's leadership and charisma, and Miller's business acumen drive this impressive growth. Furthermore, joining forces with a faction of the FSLN has expanded their power even more. They have even commenced their own weapons development program. All is proceeding according to Cipher's will. I could not be more pleased. Snake's pursuit of Peace Walker led him to an AI modeled after the boss's thought patterns. It was incomplete, but, somewhat ironically, making contact with Snake was the necessary finishing touch. Meanwhile, the scientist behind Peace Walker's locomotive control, Huey, defected to Snake's army. His presence has greatly accelerated weapons development at Mother Base. I failed to anticipate Coldman's madness, but nuclear war was averted. However, this was only after the boss AI on board Peace Walker sank itself to the bottom of the lake in what could be likened to suicide. The boss laid down her gun. Zadornov has been detained. Since this leaves my cover identity without a guardian, the Mother Base staff has taken me in.
Slightly cumbersome little menu. All right. That went on for a while. Unfortunately, he sort of talked... It didn't pause for the fact that sometimes Miller was trying to talk to me. How do I put this guy down? There we go. So I just found this, so I feel silly. Oh look, a hole in the fence. That would have been easier than climbing over. Alright, but that gave me something to play for you guys while I figured out the little situation while I navigated around. So that guy's knocked out, at least. I wonder if I can push him through the fence, actually. That'd be kind of funny, right? Can I stick him in there? Nah, probably not. Oh well. I was like, what if I just throw him over the ledge? There's a lot of audio logs in such a short game. Hey Chico, I found you.
Chico. Chico, it's me.
No! No! Go away! Go away!
Get me out of here, please!
Get off
please.
Me! Get off!
Chico, keep it down.
Go away!
Come on, take a second. Right over here. Hey, you gotta let me
over
out.
Here. You let me out, no!
Can't stay here.
Get off me! Get off!
Chico, calm down. Calm down. Don't fight it. I got Chico.
And Paz?
Not here.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure.
Is Chico able to walk?
Hold on. Not gonna happen.
You'll have to carry him out then. Okay, boss, change of plans. Haul Chico over to the rendezvous point. We'll get Posse's whereabouts out of him once he's calmed down.
Yep. They put bolts in his ankles.
I've marked the RV on your map. Okay, now carry Chico there.
Is it too late to warn you guys that there's violence versus children in this game? So now I need to find a way out. Unfortunately, I never took out the guy by the... Never mind. They replaced the guy by the gate. Just put him down carefully. Nice. Very gentle way of putting down your... Accidentally stepped on him for a second there. Doesn't exactly help with noise. Oh, God. I did not properly plan for the noise that the fence would make. That was my mistake, and I feel really bad for that. What's he doing? Is he calling the radio? What you doing, buddy? What you doing? What you think you doing? What you think you doing? It's a good thing they're all blind. Alright, let's get out of here because he probably called someone. We're going to want to get out of here before that gets bad. Yeah, during this 1 hour of Metal Gear Solid, I'm not going to suddenly get good at Metal Gear Solid. that'll be something that has to happen over the course of five. I've never, like replayed Metal Gear Solid games over and over again or anything. Oh, does he see me from here? Nope.
He thinks he sees something, but he doesn't. He sees nothing. I am a ghost.
Alright. Hopefully it'll be an entertaining series, though, because these are kind of, like, inherently comical games. They're really... Just because of how the AI works and the sound effects and everything, like, there's actually a lot of funny moments throughout. Can I reasonably sneak past him to the shore? I guess I can try. Oh no. Oh shit. Did not notice this guy was here. Boom! Bam! That was my mistake. Did not see the guy in the booth. Gotta pay attention to that. She was not there on the way in. Alright. Well, there's a lot of sleeping guys everywhere, and the problem is a lot of them can wake up.
The RV's just a little further.
Snake. Buses. What?
You reach the RV. Put the target down for a minute. How's he doing?
Oh, sorry.
Chico, where is Paz?
She's dead.
When was this recorded?
She's dead.
Okay, now use your iDroid to call the chopper for pickup. Roger that chopper request. It's headed your way now.
Just want to point out too, that guy's got, he's got a microphone jack in his chest where he was presumably listening to his own heartbeat for the longest time. I think we can actually kind of see his heartbeat there a little bit. No, that's too slow. Also, apparently that song we were listening to on the cassette only starts out as the song from the cassette, and then it gradually becomes the sounds of Paz being tortured in some way. So if we had heard the rest of the song, it starts out as just that song, but then like that must have been like a stuck in the middle with you moment, Reservoir Dogs, where a song's playing, but it's just a song that they turned on for the torture. It's actually a really nasty reveal to find out about that. As for why that whole thing was happening. It's like, why is he giving them this song? Oh. It's the torture song. Where you torture.